are you going to cope without us three to look after you in your later life? I want to know.
Thank you for all your hard work. I know that some of you have come on the wrong side of the boat, but for the rest of you, well done for getting this far. I'm really, really proud of you.
It's been great watching you grow from year 7 to year 11, and we'll miss you.
I won't!
Year 11. Good luck, and thank you for being the most amazing Year 11 group. I will forever remember Max Kelly's accidental swearing in lessons, Rob Trigg's inappropriate use of rap lyrics in his creative writing, and Brad Eden's turning from sullen, arrogant teenager into a slightly less sullen, arrogant teenager. Good luck with whatever you do next year, you will be amazing, and good luck.
Right. I must admit, to start off with, in September, with my group, I'd say that the feelings I had towards you were a robust dislike. But over the months, you know, I've grown to tolerate you, and actually quite like you now, although I hate to admit it. One or two things I will never understand is Nathan Biddle's complete inability to keep a pen in his hand and on his desk for a whole lesson. It's never happened. I've always wondered about Sophie Chant's shoes. She wears Converse every day, but I've never mentioned it, so I'll probably get into trouble with management for that. On the whole, everybody in the class is just a lovely person. You're all really polite, and I'm sure you'll all do really well in your life. Good luck with your exams, and thank you for actually turning out to be my favourite class. Good luck.
Hi, Year 11. I've been thinking about what I wanted to say about you as a collective and possibly some individuals, and it has been really difficult. I've known my class now for 3 years. So part of me wants to apologise for having to put up with me nearly every day for 3 years. So that's one thing I can say. Collectively, there are moments when you have completely and utterly done my head in. Quite a few moments, actually, like that. But on the others, you've made me laugh. You've made me really, really proud of you in some other areas. In terms of name dropping, Harry Whittaker will be expecting a mention, so I'm not going to say anything about him other than that. I will miss some of you loads, I really, really will. There are some fantastic students in my class. I wish you all the very, very best, and good luck with your exams.
Good luck to all your Year 11s in your exams, and have fun in the summer. And whatever you do in life, make sure you enjoy yourself and rock.
John Avey, that's it. John Avey. So you start off with John Avey. John Avery was just a normal guy. He went to a normal school, and then he ended up going to Northumbria University, which is not one of the kind of top universities.
But his eye went there.
It's not too good. But anyway, he was just a normal kind of person, but he had the idea of things like the iPod, the iPad and things like that. He just came from a normal kind of house, and look where he ended up. So it just shows that any person from anywhere can invent great things, really. So go ahead, if you can dream it, you can do it.
Okay, when I was at school, obviously not too long ago, I was always told not to be afraid to fail. And at the time I thought, it's never ever going to happen. And at the time, not many people know this about me, but I want to be a nun. And when I went on that Thursday in August to get my GCSE results, I actually failed RE in Latin. So my dreams of a nun were diminished at this point. So I went home and lay in a dark room. And then I had like a light bulb moment that maybe I should embrace technology. So if I hadn't failed my RE in Latin GCSE, I wouldn't have been here today and I wouldn't have got to meet and teach such a lovely Year 11s.
Good luck Year 11. It's hard to believe that time's here where you're leaving. Doesn't seem a year since the last lot left. Wish you all the best with your exams and your future. Just remember, do your best. That's all anyone can ever ask of you.
We'd like to make a message to all of Year 11 to say that we might be very scary because you only see us in the big exam situation, but honestly, we're really, really happy to look after you all. You're a lovely year group, your mocks were brilliant, we were really proud of our students, and every year when we do the exams, we come out and we look at all the 323 desks full of students doing exams all quietly, and we think, fills us full of pride because you're such good students. And you won't see us miserable stood there with the rule book and standing those serious faces, but really, we really care about how well you do, and we wish you all the very best of luck for your exams and also for your future.
Mrs. Ashworth, do you want to say anything?
No, I agree with everything you said.
But our door's always open. Come and see us if you want to see us about anything that you worry about. We really are not as scary as we look.
No, I can't forget this evening, or your face as you were leaving, but I guess.
guess that's just the way the story goes. You always smile, but in your eyes your sorrow shows. Yes, it shows. No, I can't forget tomorrow when I think of all my sorrow. Well, I had you there, but then I let you go. And now it's only fair that I should let you know. Just the way the story goes. You always smile, but in your eyes your sorrow shows. Yes, it shows.
All the best, Year 11. Especially to Alfie from Miss John, she is missing you an enormous amount.
And I hope you all enjoyed my very embarrassing prom photo when I was your age. I looked very young.
All the best. Cheers.
Good morning, Year 11. I just want to send you a big, massive hug and a big thank you for being one of the nicest Year 11s that I've ever taught. You've worked really hard for me and I was so proud of you all last week in your performances. And I hope you do really, really well and have wonderful, magical futures. So, big hug. God bless you all. Bye.
Just want to say good luck to everyone in Year 11 with whatever you do. And especially the students that I've been working with recently. It's been fantastic fun, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what happens to you in the future, because there's some fantastic talent out there in Year 11, and you really will be missed, because it has been a pleasure working with you. So, good luck!
Oh, just doing a bit of practice. There you go. Oh no! Oh, bounce off roof. To you would be practice makes perfect.
Hi everybody, it's Mrs. Ellis. I hope you're all well. I cannot believe you're in Year 11 already. It doesn't seem 2 minutes since you came up in Year 7 and when we were called 7DG, come on, we were 7DH. I wish you all the best for your exams. I'm sure you'll do superbly. You better be revising, all of you. I mean it, you better be revising. And I'll see you all at prom. Looking forward to seeing you all again. I miss you all so much. Take care. Bye.
Okay. I've been press-ganged into saying something meaningful and inspiring, inspirational, as you venture onto the next stage of your hopefully long and prosperous lives. This is the beginning of everything else, obviously. But the thing is, Year 11, life is there for the taking. It don't happen, you make it happen. So make everything happen. Seize everything, seize the day. Try everything once, apart from incest and Morris dancing. Never try either of those two. But everything else, and never say no to a party. That is the absolutely crucial thing. If there was one piece of advice I could give you, which I am giving you now, that would be it. Never say no to, however rubbish you feel, never say no to the chance of a party. And always try something, everything once, because if you don't like it, you don't have to do it again. If you do like it, you can keep doing it until you're told you have to stop. But it's been an absolute delight most of the time to demolish light fittings in your company, to forget your names habitually, regularly, embarrassingly. It's been good fun, and long may it continue. Fun mostly. Kieran Moore, for example, you went to some quite lengthy extremes to avoid lessons by getting injured on a pretty regular basis. Much admiration for the dedication to the cause on that one. It's been good. You're a great bunch of people, and if you could bottle that you would make a fortune selling it. So, you know, be good. Don't get into trouble. Always have an excuse. And see you around.
Go.
Good luck, Year 11. Wish you all the best. Probably see most of you next year anyway, because the government's made it compulsory that everyone's got to go to the age of 18. So see you back. If you're off somewhere else, enjoy the facilities, and then we'll probably see you around the community. Good luck. Bye-bye.
With Matthew of Assassin to say a few words of inspiration, I could only think of these words, and that's simply this, guys. Reach for the stars. Climb every mountain, but reach for the stars. Follow your heart's desire, but reach for the stars. And when that rainbow's shining over you, that's when all your dreams will come true.
Hi Year 11, can't believe the time has come already. I'd like to say it's been an absolute pleasure teaching all of you, particularly my Y1s, 2s, 3s and Z5s. You've been amazing, you've made me laugh. You've also made me pull my hair out, grow some grey hair so you know who you are. But the time has come to say goodbye and I just want to wish you all the best of luck. I just want to finish with a few words of wisdom, so don't forget, rejection is just redirection. And if plan A fails, there's always 25 other letters in the alphabet. So go out there and knock them dead.